So hello and welcome to all of you to today's panel, which is about the challenges of entrepreneurship and finding funding here in Barcelona. First of all, thank you to all of you for coming here. I know it's kind of like maybe a bit of an inconvenient time to be here on a Saturday, depending probably where you come from. In my case, I'm from Austria. Typically, we already finished lunch at this time. Maybe if you're from the south of Europe, maybe you haven't bought the groceries yet. So I think it depends. My name is Clemens. I'm the Chief Operating Officer from Barcino. We are the leading English-speaking media company that covers tech, startup, and innovation news here in Barcelona. So there's a newsletter going out for free every Monday. If you want to be up to date, I recommend you to sign up. We do like a recap of startup funding rounds and things like that. But more importantly, we are joined here by four experts who know way more than me about today's topic, so they will be giving you all the ins and outs. We have, starting from this side here, Lauren Arens van der Per, who is a director of venture capital at B Startup 10 of Banco Sabadell. Then next to him, we have Gifre Belloso, the business finance and business service management technician at Barcelona Activa. And then we have here two entrepreneurs, also representing the side of actual entrepreneurs here, Nicolas Escartin. First of all, Chief Operating Officer and co-founder of QBeast. And then last but definitely not least, Adria Cortez, the Chief Executive Officer and co-founder of Amphora. So maybe like a quick applause for my amazing panel here for the speakers. Thank you. To begin with, maybe with a lighter question, something to get you all warmed up. I'm gonna keep it a bit easier. We, of course, everybody here united, it's the Barcelona International Community Day. So it's logical, a lot of you may be coming from abroad and are experts here in Barcelona. There was probably a reason why you moved here. In this case, we're talking about entrepreneurship here. And Barcelona consistently ranks as one of the best places to launch a startup in the entire world. So my question, starting with Laurens, is why is Barcelona such an attractive place for entrepreneurs coming from abroad and specifically choosing Barcelona?
Okay, so good morning, everyone. So in my opinion, I think that we have a vibrant startup ecosystem here in Barcelona. We have a lot of accelerators, programs, incubators, networking events, and also global events like the Mobile World Congress years from now in February here in Barcelona, and also tech hubs, right, in biotech, in IoT, and prop tech. And we have also the 22@, is the 22 at here in Barcelona, with a lot of startups incubated here. And well, we have also a talent pool, a lot of universities in business and technology. In technology, we have Universidad Politécnica de Cataluña. In business, ESADE, IES, top worldwide ranked universities. And a lot of startups like Globo, Factorial, Wallapop, they are attracting a lot of talent worldwide to Barcelona. And finally, just seeing the climate here, or the weather in November, the quality of life in Barcelona is awesome if we compare with other countries in the north of Europe. I'm from Belgium, and we don't have this weather in Belgium. So I love this weather.
Thank you, Lauren. Gifre, what about you?
I work by the Economic Development Agency, depending on the city council. Barcelona Activa supports the entrepreneurship with specific accelerator programs. We have one focus on sport tech, another in deep tech companies. We support in that way, just giving advice and giving them also the possibility to use our premises. We have an incubator in 22@ district where the companies, newborn companies, can establish there, especially if they are innovative and they have their own product to develop. From this incubator, we have launched Globo, Hola Luz.
Gifre, sorry. We'll have that specific question for you in a second. Just for now, just wanted to know. Yeah, you're getting.
Okay.
I appreciate that you're very motivated. It's good.
Okay.
Just first, why you think that so many entrepreneurs even come into Barcelona in the first place?
In the first place, because it's an international city where there's yes, they told there an ecosystem. There's a lot of new consumers that they want to know something new. There are new startups. There are also investors. So there's the whole ecosystem, especially in different branches, as Laurent talked, biotech or IoT. There's really dynamic movement between companies and startups and corporates.
Thank you.
Sure.
No, thank you. That's great. And now, Nicolas, Alia, you're both entrepreneurs, so maybe you have a different perspective. Probably even choosing a location is probably maybe one of the first questions that may arise. So, Nicolas, in your case, why do you think that entrepreneurs come here from abroad specifically?
I mean, Barcelona is very nice. It is easy to, you wanted to tell, no? But it's also a very open city, no? It is very easy to find people looking forward to bring you services, to be next to you in the path of taking a risk, no? Or to make the proper introductions to find the next person that can support you, no? For example, I was very happy of meeting the people in Barcelona Activa. They will be very helpful, no? Not just with the spirit of service, but also bringing tools to
his company. It's incubated by Barcelona Activa in our incubator.
And it's also invested by Sabadell. And in the end, we meet these people because of the nice ecosystem there is in the city. No, the important thing is that the city is very open, no, in a cultural way. I am from Argentina, no? My country once was a great nation and was because of a motto, no? That is Argentina para el mundo, no? Argentinian for the world. No, Barcelona is a little bit the same, no? It's a city for the world. We are taking profit of this, no?
Thank you, Nicolas. And Adrià, what about you?
Well, I'm from Barcelona, so basically I didn't choose the location. But it's true that I'm second time entrepreneur. I had a previous company before to Amphora, and I was living in Brazil, in Sao Paulo. So basically at least I have comparison between Latin America and Europe. The company that I have now is so it's so much better than the first one. Basically we failed first time. And well, now we're a young company, only 3 years, but it's true that being in Barcelona, probably for me the most important thing is the talent that we can find. As Lauren said, we have UPC and very good engineering universities. In my company, most of the people are developers, and it's important to find good talent, and probably in early stages where it's not that obvious or that easy. At the same time, I think that one of the best things that Barcelona did in the last 30 years, it was the 22 arroba. And I think that the same Barcelona, they did a tech neighborhood 20 years ago when people was not talking about tech maybe that much at this time. And when you walk around Poblenou, you can feel you can feel this spirit on the people. And probably for me these are the two things that change Barcelona from maybe Madrid or other cities where the entrepreneurship is not maybe with that feeling that you have here.
Okay, thank you, great. So we have the warm-up question out of the way so we can get to some more difficult ones. I mean, the panel is also called The Challenges of Entrepreneurship, so we also want to talk about that side. And maybe as a transition, I think one of the most famous experts who ever lived in Barcelona is probably Jordi Cruyff, a famous football player, right? He used to have a great quote that I like, which is that basically every disadvantage has an advantage. And personally, I believe that the opposite is also true. So, you know, like every city, we have a lot of like great factors, obviously, that we just discussed before. But let's be realistic, like every city, we have our own challenges as well when it comes to entrepreneurship. So maybe here, starting with a bit of a tougher question, starting with Lauren, what are the main obstacles when it comes to setting up a business here in Barcelona?
Okay, so for me, three things. The first one is not Barcelona, it's Spain in general, and it's probably the bureaucracy we have to set up a business here in Spain if we compare with other countries like US or UK. And here we can improve a lot of things, in my opinion. The second one is we have a lot of talent. However, we have a lot of competition for this talent. So startups that they are starting the business have to compete with global and with big companies to attract this talent to their company. So probably is the second point. And the third point is that Barcelona is expensive. An expensive city, the rent of apartments is expensive, so when you have a low salary, it's maybe difficult to live alone here in Barcelona. It's cheaper than London, obviously, and Paris, but it's still expensive.
Great, and Gifre, anything to add on this topic? On
the challenges? Always complaining about bureaucracy, this is not fair. It's really, there are a lot of barriers to reach the ID card and all this stuff, but in Barcelona Activa you can incorporate the limited liability company in 2 hours and you have an appointment for the next 2 or 3 days to the notary. And it costs around 200 euros. I think less than 200 euros. So we have these telematic procedures to set up a limited liability. And we can incorporate and help to freelance workers. Every year we are incorporating around 500 or 600 limited liability companies in Barcelona Activa. So we have a lot of experience in that field. Okay, for example. This is an example.
Thank you, Gifre. And Nicolas, what about yourself? What are some of the biggest challenges you've seen here in the city when you launched a business?
I mean, bureaucracy is in fact one of them. The things that Gifre explained are true. They can support and facilitate the path, but still there is a lot to do. Hiring the first employee is not easy. And it not requires more than doing the interviews or the process and so on. And sometimes if you are looking forward to get talent from abroad, you find that, okay, this person cannot come to Spain so easy as we think, no? And we start to face this problem and then the bureaucracy starts again, no? But the main challenge is about talent, always. In Barcelona, for example, it's very nice that the people is looking forward to working in a startup, to take risks, to join a team, to the very talented people. It's okay, no? But the problem is that Barcelona is not a great market for a startup, no? I mean, there is a lot of projects, there is a lot of things, but it's still very easy to do this commercial approach to traditional companies or even to other startups in order to sell innovation, no? And I believe this something is still to change. Even for example, I studied with some people, no, and trying to catch them and trying to explain what I sell in my company. Still there is a barrier, even if you have the proper connection to sell innovation, no? I believe but in the end this is also a good thing for Barcelona because it helps us to see the world as a market and not just a city, not Spain, no?
Thank you, Nicolas. And Adria, what about yourself? What challenges do you see when you launch businesses here?
Well, I think at the beginning, now I don't remember because it was like 3 years ago and now we have lawyers, we have everything and the bureaucracy, other people work on that. But what I really think that's true is that in Spain, and this is not only Barcelona, in Spain in general, the laws that we have are not specifically applied to new business models like startups. And I think this is a big challenge that politics have now. They launched this startup law, you know, like in the...
Yes.
And this law is horrible. Like, I cannot understand how having like a team of experts and they cannot have like very easy concepts. I will say like an example. Okay. One of the things, you know, that we leverage on growth, new startups, and they put a line of revenue, and they define that less than 10 million revenue, you are a startup. More than 10 million, you are not a startup. But this depends a lot on the business model. It's like, it's extremely easy for a marketplace that they have a 5% margin to, well, extremely easy, no, but it's easier for a marketplace that they have 5% margin to have this revenue. And for example, for a model like mine, like a SaaS, for a software as a service, it's very difficult. We have like very high margins. And this is something that we cannot apply to this law, for example, because someone, they put like the principal metric, the revenue. You understand what I said, maybe not, no, but,
yeah.
But I think with this team of experts that they have, they could improve a lot the laws that they do for companies like us.
Thank you, Adrià. We talked a lot about challenges now, so that's obviously the bad news is there are some challenges, but it's also the reality. The good news is, though, we have two people here representing organization that can help you overcome some of those challenges. So I want to start with Lauren. Can you explain some of the services and programs that B Startup and Banco Sabadell Welcome Hub offer to entrepreneurs in Barcelona to help them with some of those?
Yeah, so basically B Startup was born 10 years ago here in Spain, in Banco Sabadell. We are the fourth bank here in Spain. And summarizing, we are the financial partner of the startups and scale-ups here in Spain with two different arms, the banking services, where we have specialized branches and specialized account managers. They are managing only startups in their portfolio, and also a specific risk circuit to approve the operations, banking operations. And we provide more than 1 billion euros in loans, and we have more than 4,000 customers, Spanish customers. And we have the other arms, is where I'm currently working, is the venture capital. And here we have two different vehicles depending the phase of the startup. The first one is B Startup 10. Here we invest in pre-seed and seed startups based in Spain, completely agnostic in terms of sector, like Cubist and Amphora. Here we invest 100K per company in 10, 13 companies per year. And we have more than 85 companies invested in our portfolio. And then we have another vehicle, it's called Sabadell Venture Capital. Here we invest in companies more mature in Series A, Series B, and with investment between 200K to 2 million euros in equity. And we have also a specific product called Venture Debt. It's an hybrid between the equity and a loan. And here we can invest tickets between 500K and 10 million euros per company.
All right, thank you, Lauren. Gifra, I know you are very eager to share because you have great services at Barcelona Activa that help entrepreneurs. Yeah. Can you give us an overview of that as well?
Yeah, my specific department helps to raise funding for every company from Barcelona. So in three ways. Banking, so we have contacts with different banks. We also help the entrepreneurs and startup companies to reach public funding. There are tools like finance instruments like finance tools like ENISA or research and development grants like Neotech, for example. So we are really focused to support the entrepreneur in that field. And also we have we intermediate between investors and startups. So we have, I think, a great list of business angels and venture capitals. So we help to boost the investment, the private investment into the startup companies. Sometimes I'm lucky and I have some success stories, but it's really difficult.
Thank you, Gifre. Moving on, I want to see the side of the entrepreneurs as well, right? To see how that has worked for you. But as an introduction, I know we're a bit behind the time, so I will try to speed this up a little bit. First of all, Nicholas, I know you and Adria probably travel a lot as business owners and running these operations. You probably, let's imagine you sit in a taxi and the taxi driver asks you what you do for a living, like what QBs does, and let's say you have only, I don't know, 50 meters left till your destination. What do you say?
Okay, this is not easy, no? But QBs is a company that helps companies that manage a large amount of data to do their data process in a cheaper and faster way. We help the companies to optimize every process in data and to save money on top of that.
Brilliant, that was very good. So now a follow-up question. You know, considering all the challenges that you may have faced when you initially set up the business, can you maybe explain, like, you know, could be related to fundraising or anything else, could you maybe explain how the support from B Startup and Boston Activa helped you overcome some of those hurdles?
Okay, something interesting about doing fundraising is that it's hard or easy at the same time. Depends on the trend you are working on. No? For example, a few years ago was easy for the companies doing digital or fintech to raise funds, but very hard for the deep techs. No? And now it seems that it's the other way around. It's more, you will raise funds if you are a deep tech, and you will not be able to raise funds if you have a digital company. No? Seems more or less that is the current trend. No? But and talking with people like Ifre, you will understand this trend. No, and see what is happening in the city, and also in the world. No, the city also is doing this. No, we are very happy because we close like very fast or pre-seed, thanks to the support of Bank Sabadell mostly. No, because there are people that is easy to talk with them. They are open to learn about the new things coming in technology and so on. And, we established like a few months of conversation explaining the details of our technology, and they were able to do the risk. No, even at the moment we didn't have, not even the company built it. So sales was far away in time. No, so without no traction, we got the investment from Sabadell. But we were on the trend. We were we have a patent. We have knowledge. We have a great team on top, and so on. No? And we explained very well the business plan with several talks. No, doing this with other business could be impossible. No, but in deep tech, it is possible. So understanding the trend. No, talking with other entrepreneurs, with people like Ifre, with people like Lauren, and so on, is very helpful to know if you can raise or not funds. No, and what is the people you need to talk to do it. No.
Thank you, Nicolas. Adria, going back to the example from before, you sitting, let's say, in the same taxi as Nicolas here, and you get asked the same question, like, what do you say? Like, what does your company do, Amphora?
Well, Amphora, we do logistics solutions for small and medium e-commerces. Basically, we have two business lines. In the first one, we outsource logistics for these e-commerces, and the second one, we have a warehouse management system, plug and play, for e-commerce also, everything for e-commerce.
Brilliant, thank you. And I know we've talked a little bit before this panel started, and you shared that you're on a pretty incredible growth journey right now. So can you maybe share, like, how, you know, some of the support systems here, we've talked Boston Activa, B Startup, helped you on this kind of like growth trajectory of your company?
Well, we are not in Barcelona Activa, but Loren and Banco Sabadell, they were investors from the early beginning. We started 3 years ago, and they invest with B Startup a ticket of 100,000. We have more VCs in our cap table. I think now we have like four, and of course it's very important to have good VCs in your cap table, because probably Bank Sabadell, they have other 40 startups that they cross along all the challenges that we have, and they help us a lot during the journey. We started three years ago, and it's true that now the venture capital is getting harder and harder, because I think probably at the beginning, and Lauren will tell me this, they were extremely focused on growth, and now they want everything. They want growth and profitability. and it's true that in Amphora, we had a big growth in the last 3 years. We started 3 years ago, and this year we are going to close with more than 12 million euros revenue. And now we are trying to bootstrap as much as we can. We are capital efficient, very capital efficient. We are money, that it's not that obvious in our world. What we try to do is when we get money from VC, basically you get diluted on your equity, that's very important. You need to know where you're going to invest this money to transform it in growth. If you don't know how to do this, then it does not make sense to raise more money.
Thank you very much. I know we're a bit short on time. I want to make sure there's going to be time for questions, so I'm going to skip through some questions. And also, I want to lighten the mood a little bit, because we talked a lot about challenges, so I want to maybe give something more positive to aspiring entrepreneurs here. So maybe, Nicola, starting with you, can you maybe say what was your most enjoyable moment as a business founder here in Barcelona?
Barcelona is very... It's interesting, no? You can find people in very different environments, no? Once I was in a barbecue, and I met an student that was doing a master on big data I believe was the University of Navarra, but he was here in Barcelona because he had friends and so on. And I explained, hey, what do you do? No, I have a startup in Barcelona, Cubis. Oh, I studied in the master the open source you are doing. And I was like, wow. You know, it is amazing the impact of the things you can do and you are not aware, no? And are things that you will know if you are not living in a city like Barcelona, that you have the possibility of meeting random people so easy, no? Maybe you can do the same. You can build the same technology from a city that is in the middle of the desert. The impact will be the same, but you will know. You will not know.
Thank you. And Adria, for you, what is your example of your most enjoyable moment in this, let's say, crazy journey of an entrepreneur?
I think that when you put now in Amphora we are 70 people. And when you have an objective and you put all these people working on the same objective, a lot of things happens. And you can see from the beginning that in Amphora at least, we are very young. I think I'm one of the oldest ones and I'm 32 years old. But we are working on day to day. We're very focused on what we do. And this journey is probably the job that I had that I enjoyed most, for sure.
Brilliant, thank you. And I want to move back to the other side of the table here, so I don't want to neglect both of you here. I want to start with Lauren. I think Adria touched on this a little bit. All across the world, and Barcelona is no exception here, one of the biggest challenges I think this year and the last year has been the question of raising funds. I mean, it's just a reality. In your experience, I mean, you work as the director for venture capital. What advice do you give to entrepreneurs in this climate specifically to look for funding?
Okay, so here it depends the phase of the startup. It's not the same if you are raising your phase round or a Series A. If you are setting up a business here in Barcelona, my recommendation is to prepare a strong pitch, a strong deck, and a strong business plan where the VC can see the growth of your startup and the potential of your business, then I think that network is really important. You have to build a strong network with startups, with the whole ecosystem like Barcelona Activa, banks, other VCs, not just in Barcelona, but also in Spain, in Europe, when you will rise a next round. And be realistic with your enterprise value, be realistic with your business plan, and be realistic with the time you... So when you are rising around, normally it's the average time between you make the first contact with the first investor and the closing deal, and the closing deal is when you sign on the notary, not when you have the term sheet. The average time is between 6 months and 8 months. So you have to think about these numbers and prepare your cash in your bank when you raise this money, because it's better to negotiate with a VC or with a bank, with anything, when you have money in the bank than if you don't have money.
Thank you. And Gifford, I have a specific question for you in 1 second, but in one sentence or less. I know you have experience in this as well. Anything else you would like to add to this?
Yeah. There's a lot of people asking for money. So, yeah. So if you don't want to be boring, just to try to ask for advice, just try to create a business advisory board, so you can launch once a month with a specific person, guy, who can help you in some field of your business. Also, you have to attend some events, networking events, just to have a network that when you are mature to close or to open a round, you are successful to that. Because private investment is not a long trip, it's a spring, okay? So you have to do it in a short time, and you have you need the arguments to convince the investor that this is a great investment in you and your company. So I think it's the best way to be successful in that field, okay?
Thank you, Gifre. And I want to also touch on your experience because, you know, you work in Barcelona Activa, so I think you probably have the best knowledge of how to navigate some of the bureaucratic and administrative processes here when somebody wants to launch a new business. Do you have any quick advice that you could share in like a few sentences here?
Be passionate. Okay, train yoga or something like that. No, the main problem that we got that we have different levels of public administration. One administration launch a regulation that the other don't know, and so this kind of stuff. But we are, as Barcelona Activa, we try to the user experience to be more soft. But it's true, if you want to set up a restaurant in L'Eixample, there's a lot of procedures, activity license, regulations that you have to accomplish. But it's true. Of if you want to reach the ID, it's really difficult. Also, we have also a welcome desk and a specific advisory team that can help to solve all your worries about how to set up a company and so on. And they speak three guys speak 9 languages and so on. So they are a really good prepared team on that. Okay, so.
Brilliant, thank you. All right, we want to make sure we have time for some question and answers, so I'll keep this last question as kind of like a speed round here, okay? My idea is, you know, each of you, in their own sense, you're major pillars of the startup ecosystem here. You're very much involved in the day-to-day, in the community, you experience firsthand what's going on, so this is, again, a speed round. So one sentence for each of you. How do you feel about the future of entrepreneurship in Barcelona? Lauren, we're starting with you.
Well,
one sentence, eh?
One sentence. Well, it's difficult question. I think that we can improve a lot of things, but we have a strong ecosystem for VCs, for startups, for accelerators.
Thank you. And Gifre, what about you?
Yes, we have a strong ecosystem, so in the next 10 years we multiply that in a lot of fields, so I think it's a successful series here.
Yeah, we have to grow more and more and more.
Yeah.
The objective.
All right, thank you. And Nicolas, how do you feel about the future?
I see the future amazing, no? Entrepreneurship is about waves, no? There is a first wave of entrepreneurs, the second, and now we're maybe in the third and the fourth, no? With a lot of employees in our companies that in 10 years will be the next entrepreneurs, no? And this would be amazing. He has 70 employees, so I cannot imagine the future.
Adrià, what about yourself?
Well, I think that in this last year or two, that VCs are focusing in, and they are not investing on everything, and not every company. The startups that we have now, that they passed like these 2 years, are more resilient, and this is interesting, and probably the ecosystem will get harder for this.
Fantastic, thank you all of you. We have like 6 minutes for question and answers from the audience, so please raise your hand if you want to ask. Okay, we have one over here. Let's just wait till the micro arrives. Thank
you. My name is Kate Maria Winter, and I'm a founder of the startup Lagitha that I moved from Copenhagen to Barcelona 1 year and 4 months ago. Sorry, my voice. There's one thing before I ask the question. I actually missed some female founders up there. And the next question, this is, are you sure that we really need to focus so much on funding and not on developing your business? We, for 1 year now, we have actually redesigned our own startup program. And it's not, we found out that there's like 5 biggest challenges for you to survive your first 2-3 years. And this is not founding. This is actually the biggest question. This is to create your co-partner team. And with that, your co-partner team, you will actually find solution for the last 4 questions. So is founding really the biggest question, biggest like challenge?
Great, so I think there were like 2 questions in one. So first of all, can you just keep the mic for a second? Just, yeah. The first part, personally I agree. I think when I've done research on this panel, all the other panels at this International Barcelona Community Day are overwhelmingly represented by females, but much more than male, but I agree it would be nice for next year to make sure we have much more female representation here, but please speak with the organizer. I want to get into trouble here for myself. But can you just say to who the question is addressed, or is it like a general question you want to see?
It's just a general question, because actually, mm-hmm. for now, we have seen the last 3 years how the percentages of startups is failing. We have 19% of startup failures in Europe for the time being, which is really, really bad for Europe's innovation. And I think this is actually why we started to not our startup program were actually much more focusing on specific global industries. Now we totally redesigned it, and it's like for everybody, and it have the focus on surviving, and it's like we designed it in 8 different modules, only focusing on how to survive the very most important skills, which is first the co-partner team, and then the rest is there. This is hard. This is like focusing on building your business, not focusing on. I mean, I've been there myself. I went to the trap myself several times, even that I did not know, because my advisory board did push me. But you see what's happening if you are like a competitive person, which I am. You get in your competitive mode, and you suddenly have lost like 4-5 months. Trying to find your the right investor. It's like a jungle. I just want to say that.
Yeah.
So you lose focus on building your business. You lose focus on building your business model. Yeah. So I mean, I don't know. I think you from. I'm sorry, I don't remember your name, but you said actually something in the end.
It's if you have to find an investor, it's not 10 months looking for an investor and then appear in event or something like that.
Focus on your business.
Yeah, but you need the arguments for the investor, because the investor needs metrics. We have a problem, not a problem, but there's the death of ballet of the startups, typical. When we finish, we have all the procedures to build a business plan, a great deck, and so on. But after that, there's an spaghetti period. The people have to eat spaghettis to build their own business before they are more mature to reach the private investment. Because the private investment here, if I compare with international experience in London or Paris or so on, it's easier to reach this business angel investment at first sight. The valuation are higher than here, okay, for the companies that are invested. And it's difficult to reach private investment, because you need to prove that your business is working.
Yeah, but what I'm actually trying to say here, this is like, you know, I see we work with in universities also, and unfortunately the universities are focusing very much on finding funding. This is what young people are taught today. And that gift from the first, you know, if you want to make your startup, that gives you the wrong focus, and they think it's this is what they have to do.
Yeah.
Okay, to put up your startup, you have to go out and find funding.
Yeah.
Okay. I think Nicolas wanted to touch on this, actually.
The thing is, you are right in the sense that the entrepreneur should focus on business. But depending on the business requires investment. Our business is capital intensive. We have a team of 20, next to 20 high qualified people, and we don't have revenues. And it's not because we are not focusing on sales, focusing on creating community, focusing on business. It is because we require a lot of development. No? So investment is not for every kind of business. Some business, are impossible to build if you don't have this startup investment. No? And the relationship with universities is that I'm not talking about business schools. I'm talking research centers, computer science, biology, and so on, or the hard science. No, that are starting to bring new entrepreneurs to the ecosystem. Most of them, they came with their ideas. They start to, as you can ask Gifre, no, they start to start business, but very fast they realize that the amount of capital required in order to achieve the threshold of being a business require investment. So for most of the projects coming from universities, nowadays like mandatory to raise funds, no? And that's why there is a focus on creating the relationship of the investment community and the university, no? But the investment is not for everybody, no? And this is something it's important to explain. No?
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Just very quickly, organizers, do we have time for one more question? Or no, okay. So I'm sorry for that. I do know that maybe some people from the panel will be around, so definitely feel free to reach out to them. If not, I'm sure you can connect with them on LinkedIn. You'll find them there. Also Barcelona Activa, B Startup, they have their corporate website, so you can reach out there too. And yeah, thank you for being here. Thanks to the speakers. Can we just give them an applause for... Thank you so much.
Thank you.